One beautiful thing with Karna, he has done so much punya by dana. Hey, listen, I tell you, there are multiple levels, purposes about dana and dharma and charity in Hindu tradition. Maybe in some satsang I'll explain. Now I'll just give you a few lines. See, there are some kind of charities done to keep the concept and value of currency alive. See, if you make people feel currency is not reachable at all, it's very difficult to get it. Currency will lose its value. Understand? If too much of currency is available, it will lose its value. Like you will have to carry $1 billion for your petrol bunk. There are some countries where $1 billion bills have come, $1 million bills have come, but no value. If too much is available, it will not have value. And same way, if it is too difficult to get it, it will not have value. To keep the greed of the common man on currency alive, but not to make too much available and to make him work towards that false idea of currency, the value of the currency is kept. For that, the actions done is called dharma. Listen, in yaga yagnas, large yagas, kings will do this charity. Whoever comes, they are given. That is actually the way of keeping the currency's value alive. Whatever the king decides should be valued in his country, he will do that as dharma. It is dharma with the purpose of keeping the value of that currency alive in the society. If that king feels pearls is the largest gem available in the country and he wants the value of the pearls to be really kept current, then he will do dana of pearls. So the whole city knows, wow, pearls are important, pearls are important, pearls are important. Understand, what I am talking is a very subtle economic principle. Listen, all the big charity done by the big, big billionaires, trillionaires is just this. They want to keep the value of the currency. They want to make a common man still have hope of achieving currency, so he is forced to work continuously. Listen, I will never believe the charity of trillionaires. If you are having the charity mind, you will not be waiting to make trillions and then start your charity. All right, let's not get into that subject. Leave it. Let me talk about only how the Hindu kings kept the currency current. Currency need to be, currency will be kept current only if the greed and hope is kept alive. See, neither people should have too much, nor they should lose hope that they are never going to get it. So the currency can be kept alive, currency can be kept current only if there is a balance between availability and non-availability. To keep that balance, certain actions are done as a homa, Yaha, Yanya, a large kind of charities are organized. See, in Hindu tradition, it says that kings from multiple nations will come with the best things available in their kingdom and do large quantity of charity in Kumbh Mela. For example, the Pandya Raja will come with like huge quantity of pearls and large elephants and do dana of that pearls in Kumbh Mela. Why? Doing good is one. Next, the concept of pearl, and pearl is precious, pearl is valuable, is promoted among the millions of people. Understand? Each nation brings their best. Through dana, they promote it, make it as current in common man's life. Same way only the diamond. All the precious gems are kept alive and current. Chola Raja will go with large varieties and different kinds of rice. And not only give food, give charity of the grains also. Pallavas will go with large, various quality and quantity of silk dress and establish their brand. Understand? Any purpose associated with charity becomes dharma. Not dana. No purpose associated socially, morally, in any sense, and no direct, indirect benefits are expected, a pure giving is dana. Karna has gained so much punya by the pure dana. Now, if he wants, he can live as Indra due to that punya. But Krishna knows liberation, enlightenment, moksha is much more than living as Indra. And he goes and stands in front of Karna. Last moment. And asks Karna, Karna, give me all the punya you have earned. Please understand, Karna knows it is Krishna, not some ordinary Brahmana. He knows it is Krishna. Read Mahabharata. When Karna gives dana, that whole statement clearly shows Karna knows it is Krishna. Hey, I tell you, listen. If you read the original verse, when Karna is giving his Kavacha Kundala to Indra, the way he addresses the receiver, it shows very clearly Karna knows it is Indra taking dana with the ulterior motive. The sarcasm Karna is expressing when he is giving dana and the reverence with which he is addressing the receiver, you can see very clearly Karna knows it is Indra who is receiving. Same way, when Karna is giving all his punya, the reverence and devotion he demonstrates in the words, Karna knows it is Krishna receiving. Listen carefully. Listen. Both Indra also came as an old Brahmin. Krishna also goes as an old Brahmin. Because an old Brahmin will never be denied. Both come in the same disguise. But if you read the statements of Karna, you will know very clearly he is not getting cheated. He knows to whom he is giving and the side effects and after effects. But giver is a giver is a giver. Mahadani Karna. I think that Surya's DNA, Surya's quality of giving is in the DNA of Karna. If you read the statements Karna uttering when he gives his Kavacha Kundala armor to Indra, and the statements Karna is uttering when he gives his punya to Krishna, you will see very clearly Karna knows what he is doing and to whom he is giving. Anyhow, Krishna receives it and gives liberation. And I tell you, actually I wanted to explain the glory of Krishna, but I ended up in explaining the glory of Karna. Anyhow, here both need to be glorified for their role in this whole psychodrama. When Karna gives all the punya, immediately Krishna reveals his Vishwarupa. One side giving moksha to Karna, other side telling Arjuna, now send the arrows. Because all the Arjuna's arrows were not affecting Karna, because Dharma Devata is punya. The punya of Karna was protecting him. No arrows were able to touch. Now Krishna has taken away all the punya. So Arjuna's arrows killed Karna. And Krishna liberated Karna.